Hi, this is Jaya. Now we shall see the summary of Herman Melville's Billy Budd Sailor. Herman Melville is an American novelist, short story writer, and he's also a poet belonging to the American Renaissance period. And his best works are Moby Dick and Typee. And in this Billy Budd, we see Billy Budd as a sailor. He is a very young sailor and he is working in a merchant ship. Merchant ship means a ship which carries goods from one country to another. And the name of the ship is Rights of Man. And this Billy is a very handsome, young, innocent and charming and good-natured person. Thing is, he's a foundling. Foundling means his parents have abandoned him, so he does not have a family. He does not know who his parents are. And another thing is, he has one weakness. Suppose in case if he is overcome by strong emotion, he will start stammering. He won't be able to talk properly. And that is the time when this British Empire had problems, because Napoleon's ambitions were spreading all over the world, and France's French Revolution was catching the world. And here the Navy, in the Navy they were very few people. So what happened is they had to be prepared for any mutiny. So they had to have more and more people in the Navy. So they were forcing the others also to send whoever were trained in the ship to the Navy. And Billy's merchant ship also was boarded by the HMS. And what happened is the Lieutenant Radcliffe, he chooses Billy because he found that everyone loved him and he was very good natured. So he thought that if Billy goes there, he can impress everyone and he will also be very happy. But Captain Greville protests. He says that in this merchant ship, Billy is needed because he is the one who makes peace among the people who are about to have a fight, and he is very good natured and he makes everyone in good spirits. But finally, they have no other choice, so they send Billy to the to the Navy. So what happens is, actually when Billy is going, he says goodbye to you, old Rights of Man. And in the end, you will know it is something which he already knew what is going to happen to him, or whether it is a prophecy. Now, when Billy comes to this new ship, everything is very easy for him. Everyone starts liking him and he also starts enjoying his birthday. And soon he becomes the center of attraction. But thing is, everyone likes him and everyone loves to talk with him, whether they are officers or even the aged people, everyone. Only thing is, he gets attention of the John Claggett. Now, this John Claggett gets obsessed with Billy, and he feels that Billy has certain qualities which he does not have. And through his corporates, like, he doesn't interfere in Billy's works directly, but the people who are under him, the corporals, he tries through them to put Billy in his position. Like, even if he makes a small mistake or some carelessness, immediately he is being pointed out. But he himself gives very good, like, when he is talking with Billy, he talks to him in a very nice way, and Billy starts believing that he likes him a lot. And there's one person called as Dansker. He's a old sailor. He's been there for there in the ship for a long time, and he becomes a friend of Billy, and he warns him about Claggett. But Billy is not able to believe what Dansker tells about Claggett, because he thinks, why should Claggett have anything against me, because I'm only working here, and whenever he sees me, he talks with me nicely. And one day what happened is, one person approaches Billy and he says whether if there is a mutiny in the ship, whether he will help him. And Billy is surprised. He's asking why such a thing is, why he is asking like this. And since he is very frightened and he is also new and he is very young, he doesn't tell this to the officers. But he is very sure that a mutiny is going to come up, because such a question has come to him. But he tells it to Dansker, and Dansker tells him, definitely Claggett is behind this setup, so be careful. But even Dansker doesn't want to get directly involved in this, so he tells Billy, you do whatever you want, you just be careful, that's all. And now what happened is Claggett's hatred for Billy keeps on growing. And finally what happened is there's another person called Captain Very. He tells that the mutiny really happens. And then afterwards Captain Very says that the person behind the mutiny is Billy. And Claggett says, no, I cannot believe. So both of you come, Very and Claggett, you come to my cabin and we'll discuss. And when Claggett puts an accusation on Billy, Billy overcomes with emotion. And already we saw that when he overcomes with emotion, he starts stammering. And so he's stammering and he is not able to express himself. And he doesn't know how to defend him. His point, and in order to defend him, without knowing what he does, is he punches off Claggett, and Billy is so strong that Claggett dies, and Very is really sorry for Billy in his heart, but he has no other way, so he calls the court to decide Billy's case, and Billy answers whatever they asked in the court, and Very also comes and he argues in the court, but Very has very little choice because Billy has killed an officer, and this cannot be allowed in a navy. So what happened is they say that Billy has to be executed because he was the reason for the mutiny. Another thing is killing an officer, and everything becomes very clear because a crewman has killed an officer, and so the crewman must die. That is Billy. So the court convicts Billy, and the very next day itself, morning, he is hanged. But before he dies, he sees a beautiful vision. And all the sailors are looking at him, and they find Billy very beautiful. And before being hanged, Billy cries out, God bless Captain Very. And all the crew members starts echoing what he said. And then finally, the sunlight touches him, and his body is hanging. And he looks divine, like he looks like God. And the best part is, usually when someone is hanged, we find many seabirds coming and eating the body. But here nothing touches Billy's body. Within a short time, what happens is Very gets wounded, and it is fatal. Fatal means he's about to die. And before he dies, he hears Billy Bird's name being murmured in his ears. Every soldiers, they'll keep the track of the place where Billy was hanged, and everyone knew that Billy was innocent, and they find a piece of a spar, that is it is like a cross, the place where he was hanged, they can see a cross, and this novella means not a lengthy one like a novel, or not a very short story, it's somewhere in between. This finishes with a song, and this song is composed by one of the sailors who was with Billy, and he calls the song as Billy in the Darbes, that is Billy in irons. You know, irons means chains, and when they are singing the song, they can see the dead body of Billy down into the sea, and when the song's last line, it is saying that Billy is in chains and he is waiting for his death, and he is imagining himself at the bottom of the sea, and he asks for his chains to be loosened, saying that I am sleepy and the oozy weeds about me twist. This is the last line of the book. This is a very sad story. It is tragic, and we find that an innocent man is made to commit a crime, and he is being punished for his crime. This is also one of the famous stories of Melville. If you have anything to add on to this, please write it in the comment box. Like the video, share it with your friends, and if you have not subscribed my channel, please subscribe. Thank you.